Hi friends! So I thought I'd start the video off by answering one of my most asked questions, which is how much walking do you do to lose weight? You just have to start somewhere. When I first started, guys, I said this in another video, I barely could take 50 steps. Over the summer, I've gotten myself up to 3 miles. Do I walk 3 miles every day? No, but I make a point to move every day. The most important thing you can do for your body when you're first starting out on your weight loss journey is just move. If that's walking 50 steps, if that's walking 3 miles, if that's doing Leslie Sansun in your living room, the point is just to move. The more movement you do, the more freedom you will experience.
Your daily reminder: stay hydrated. My goal is to drink 3 to 4 of these a day right now, but my ultimate goal is to drink 1 gallon a day. 1 gallon of water a day. Get yourself something cute. Mine happens to be Pioneer Woman because I'm obsessed. And drink your water.
Invest in you. Buy things that are going to help you along. I got this for $3 at Walmart in my favorite color, and it'll help me track how many ounces, what I'm doing. He's waiting to go on walkies. So I'm getting ready to fill up my bottle. Water is so important, and I'm trying to drink a lot more. This is a tool to help me, and I invested in me. Okay friends, I have a delicious fall recipe for you that is low carb and very yummy. And all you will need is a butternut squash. You will need either kielbasa or some kind of sausage, some Parmesan cheese, and some sharp cheddar. It is so good and you are going to love it. So the first thing you're going to do is peel the outside of your butternut squash. I just use a vegetable peeler for that. You're going to cut your butternut squash in half and take out all the seeds just like you would a pumpkin. And then you're going to dice up your butternut squash into little bite-sized chunks. Then you're going to put it in a pan and you're going to pour a little bit of olive oil or vegetable oil, whatever you have on it, very lightly, salt and pepper it, and put it in the oven at 475 and cook it for 20 minutes. We're going to cook the butternut squash for 20 minutes by itself because it will take longer to cook than your protein. Today, I looked for some sausage, but I couldn't find any that I like, so I'm going to be using kielbasa. So even for sausage or kielbasa, your butternut squash is going to take longer to cook than your protein. So that's why we're going to put it in a pan before we add the protein. So you're going to do this in steps, but oh my goodness, is it so worth it? It is so yummy. It tastes like fall, and it is low carb, and it is so good. So while your butternut squash is cooking, you're going to prepare your protein. So all I'm going to do is slice up my kielbasa. If I could have found some kind of sausage that was kind of like the kielbasa, I probably would have preferred that because kielbasa can be kind of high in salt. But I do like kielbasa, and it did pair very, very well with the butternut squash. So whatever your favorite kind of protein would be for this kind of meal, I would just suggest to use. If you like, I know Aldi's has some really good like chicken sausages and things like that. That would be great for this recipe. It's just that I wanted to make this kind of close to the recipe that I saw, and that was with kielbasa. So, and it actually paired very, very well. So once the butternut squash has cooked for 20 minutes, we're just going to add the protein. We're going to mix it all over, try to turn the butternut squash over from the side that it first cooked on for 20 minutes, add the protein, and then put it back in the oven for another 20 minutes because the kielbasa is raw. I would imagine if you kind of find a sausage the same way or a chicken sausage, it would be raw too. So just cook your protein and the butternut squash again for another 20 minutes. I'm telling you guys, it's a little bit of a longer and a little bit of a process, but it is so good, and it definitely is a wonderful fall treat. It tastes like fall. It's so worth the wait. It is so yummy. And then your last step before serving, this is the best part, in my opinion, is you're going to top the butternut squash and now the cooked protein, which I'm, again, using kielbasa, with a nice helping. I used one handful each, which was probably like a half a cup, depending on, you know, your handfuls. I use a generous handful, but a half a cup, I would have to say, probably a Parmesan cheese and sharp cheddar. And I just cover that all up after I mix it all up, and I stick it back in the oven for about 10 more minutes until it is cheesy and bubbly and gooey. And then I'm going to go ahead and plate that up. And this makes an absolute wonderful lunch. That's what I made it for. But if you wanted to serve this like as a dinner, you could serve this as your main meal with a salad. And that would be a fantastic dinner. If you love squash and you just love like fall treats, this was so good, guys. It was so yummy. I highly recommend this recipe. If you're looking for something low carb, but yet fall and yummy, I would definitely make this. If you do, let me know how you guys think about it. You guys can chat with me over on Instagram. I'll be posting a picture here soon of this plate. So if you make it, let me know under the picture in the comments what you thought of this delicious fall dish. I thought it was fantastic. I thoroughly enjoyed it. So I was working on my personal like journal, food journal that I keep. I do cute little things in it just to make it like interesting, and I log my food and I log what I exercised, how much water I drink, my steps for the day. I journal a little bit about how I'm feeling and stuff, and just to make it pretty, you know, I add a few little decorative things to it and just to make it fun for myself. So I was taking care of that today, and how I do some of that is I, you know, look in some of my favorite magazines and I cut out clippings, and, you know, I have some stickers and stuff just to make it fun. But my point was, in one of my favorite magazines, which is, I think this is Real Simple, I took the cover off of it. There was this recipe in here. Look at this. I think this is going to be the next recipe that I try. So it is buffalo cauliflower with yogurt ranch. This looks awesome. So you cut up a head of cauliflower, put a little olive oil and kosher salt on it, and then cook the cauliflower. Then you get your favorite either like buffalo style hot sauce, or you can make your own however you want. And you're going to like top this and then make yourself some homemade ranch dressing. But instead of using like milk and sour cream and stuff, which is high in fat, they used Greek yogurt and made like, it's supposed to be like a mock of like buffalo wings, but instead of the wings, it's the cauliflower. That looks so good. I think this is going to be one of the new recipes that I try. I love trying new recipes. And then this one would be a little bit more
fatty, if you will, but this does look really good. And I love butternut squash, as you can tell, we just made that recipe. But this is creamy butternut squash with pasta and leeks. And even I'm not crazy about leeks, but I was thinking about instead of using leeks, using artichokes. But this looks really, really good, and it tells you how to make like the sauce, which is the mashed butternut squash, half and half, sage and freshly ground pepper and Parmesan cheese. And that kind of makes the sauce to put over the noodles. And even if you didn't want to put it over noodles and kind of keep this low carb even, I wonder how the same exact recipe instead of the noodles, if you would do it on spaghetti squash. Or if that's squash on squash and it would make it taste weird, I don't know, but I would be tempted to try this on spaghetti squash, and I would take out the leeks and I would exchange the leeks for artichokes. But this looks really good too. But I am really, really, really excited about this. I think this is going to be in one of the next videos because I think this is going to be a really fun recipe. That looks really, really good. So I thought I'd share that with you guys. So sometimes I get recipes out of magazines and things, and this is just one of my like little pastimes. I love to just sit down with magazines and take fun little piece clippings and cut things out. Like I'll cut all these little pumpkins and stuff out, and I have like I love stickers. I love stickers and books and stuff. So I have like all these cute little stickers, and I just love doing little things. But keeping a food record for me is always helps. It's very, very important because then I recognize what I eat. And like, let's say I go through a whole week and I weigh myself at the end of the week and I gained 2 pounds. Well, I can go back and look and see what I ate and maybe be able to pinpoint, this may be where I lost it. Maybe we need to cut back on that, blah, 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 blah. And same thing, maybe I had a really good week and I go weigh myself and I lost 2, 3, 4 pounds. Well, then I know that those things work for me and I can continue to repeat those over and over again in the coming weeks. So I feel like writing down your food in like a food diary is wonderful. And then I always write emotionally how I feel and stuff. It's just wonderful to go back and look at, what kind of exercises you did, how much water you drank, how many steps I took in the day. And then just to make it fun, I use stickers and like clippings from magazines and such. So just one of my tips and just thought I'd show you that today. When it comes to walking, don't be afraid to go off the beaten path. Well, I was walking at one of my favorite parks, I found this little trail and was like, maybe we'll go and see where this leads. And I was so pleasantly surprised. It led to this beautiful little bridge out in the middle of nowhere. And I really just let myself go. And I find that this is a very helpful tip because sometimes, just like going to the gym every day or doing the same videotapes, exercise videotapes every day, it can become mundane and boring. So to spice up walking, which is very natural movement, your body usually responds very well to this. Try going off the beaten path one time. Try exploring. Push your body just a little bit. Today I pushed my body because I wanted to go down to the water. This little bridge took me to this place where the water was, and it was very high up, and I had to go down a hill. And mentally you were like, okay, I think I can get down the hill, but am I going to get back up the hill? And I did. I made it just fine. Push yourself sometimes. You'll be surprised when you go off the beaten path what you may find and the beauty that lays. And in your mind, I was always battling in my mind all the time when I was heavier in the 500s. What if I get out too far and I'm too tired, or my legs give out on me and I can't come back? Or what if I get down this hill and I can't get back up this hill? If you live your whole life in what ifs, you'll miss out on so much. Now, don't take me wrong. There are limitations when you are first starting out, and you know your body. And I've been doing this all summer, so I know my body, and I'm to the point where I know I can push myself a little bit further than I normally can and try some new things. Would I have done this 4 or 5 months ago? Probably not. But my point being is if that's where you're at the beginning and you don't think you could trust yourself going off the beaten path just yet because you're building up stamina and lung capacity and all of these things, this is where you're headed. And for me, seeing myself do this makes me so proud. And I think to myself, 4 or 5 months from now, what might I be doing? And I'll share with you one of my personal goals, which is 4 or 5 months from now, hopefully spring, because we are going into the winter months,
before spring, my goal is to get on a bicycle and start bicycling 4, 5, 6 miles. And of course, when I start bicycling, I probably will only be able to go a couple hundred feet. But by the end of next summer of 2022, I hope I can bicycle 4 to 5 miles. So every progression that you make, it takes you further and further and further. So if you're at the beginning and you're just walking a quarter of a mile in a circle at a park somewhere, fantastic. In a few months, you might be exploring paths that you just happen to find somewhere you would never go before and discover beauty that you've never seen before. Let me tell you, when I went back into this wooden path and I found this little bridge and it was all beautiful and I was just so elated and I was just like, wow, look what I would have missed if I would have been stuck in the what ifs. And I'm telling you, in your journey, you will get there too. If you just keep pushing and keep trying every day, you will make progression. The point is to just get up and move. Every day movement, every day move will lead into more and more and more. It's just like a baby. When a baby starts to crawl, sometimes they scoot, then they crawl, then they walk. And it's the same thing with this. Just start somewhere. And I'm telling you, in a few months, you'll be doing things that totally amaze yourself. Know that I love you guys. Know that I think that you're worth it. You are worth it. You are important and you are beautiful. And you are freedom from being a plus size person and being stuck in the what ifs lays just ahead of you. Just keep moving, keep breathing, one foot in front of the other. I believe in you. You can do this. We'll chat soon. Bye, guys.